the lover hath no desire to save union with his beloved, nor shall the seeker reach his goal unless he sacrifice all things, that is, whatever he hath seen and heard and understood, all must be said and done, that he may enter the realm of the Spirit, which is the city of God. Labor is needed if we are to seek him. Ardor is needed if we are to drink of the honey of reunion with him. And if we taste of this cup, we shall cast away the world.
The beloved of the Lord must stand fixed as the mountains, firm as impregnable walls. Unmoved must they remain by even the direst adversities, ungrieved by the worst of disasters. Let them cling to the hem of Almighty God and put their faith in the beauty of the Most High. Let them lean on the unfailing help that cometh from the ancient kingdom and depend on the care and protection of the generous Lord. Let them at all times refresh and restore themselves with the dews of heavenly grace and with the breaths of the Holy Spirit revive and renew themselves from moment to moment. Let them rise up to serve their Lord and do all in their power to scatter his breathings of holiness far and wide.
Your duty in this day is to purify your characters, to correct your manner and improve your conduct. The beloved of the merciful must show forth such character and conduct among his creatures, that the fragrance of their holiness may shed upon the whole world and may quicken the dead, inasmuch as the purpose of the manifestation of God and the dawning of the limitless lights of the invisible is to educate the souls of men and refine the character of every living man, so that blessed individuals who have freed themselves from the murk of the animal world shall rise up with those qualities which are the adornings of the reality of man. The purpose is that earthlings should turn into the people of heaven, and those who walk in darkness should come into the light, and those who are excluded should join the inner circle of the kingdom, and those who are as nothing should become intimates of the everlasting glory. It is that the portionless should gain their share of the boundless sea, and the ignorant drink their fill from the living fount of knowledge. That those who thirst for blood should forsake their savagery, and those who are barbed of claw should turn gentle and forbearing, and those who love war should seek instead for true conciliation. Unless these divine bestowals be revealed from the inner self of humankind, the bounty of the manifestation will prove barren, and the dazzling rays of the Sun of Truth will have no effect whatsoever. Wherefore, O Lord, strive ye with heart and soul to receive a share of his holy attributes, and take your portion of the bounties of his sanctity, that ye may become the tokens of unity, the standards of singleness, and seek out the meaning of oneness, that ye may, in this garden of God, lift up your voices and sing the blissful anthems of the Spirit. Become ye as the birds who offer him their thanks, and in the blossoming bowers of life chant ye such melodies as will dazzle the minds of those who know. Raise ye a banner on the highest peaks of the world, a flag of God's favor to ripple and wave in the winds of his grace. Plant ye a tree in the field of life, amid the roses of this visible world, that will yield a fruitage fresh and sweet.
Prayer by Bahá'u'lláh was revealed for the protection of Bahá'ís in prison and under persecution in the early days of the faith in the 19th century. And sadly, nearly two centuries later, it was cost for us to invoke this. I'll read the original in Arabic, followed by the original translation. إنه الله المقدر المختار يا مالك الأسماء والفاطر السماء خلص الأحباء من سجن الأعداء إنك سلطان القضاء و مشرق من حكم البدا یا اصل البقا لامر البها لا تحت هم رجا فنسر خب الله انت حاکم على ما تشا و فی قبصتکم على خود الانشا قد شهد الانیاب للحن الاحباب ان احفظ الاحباب یا مالک البقا و حاکم فی المعاب. He verily is the all-powerful, the unconstrained, O Lord of all names and creator of the heavens. Deliver thy loved ones from the prison of their enemies. Thou art verily the king of our destiny, who shineth in the horizon of creation. O thou essence of eternity, by the life of Baha, sever not the cord of their hope. Assist thy loved ones, O Lord. Thou ordainest that which pleaseth thee, and in thy grasp lieth the kingdom of creation. Fangs have been honed for the flesh of thy loved ones. Protect thy companions, O thou who rulest over all men. and ordain us, God.